One of the great statements made in the Bible was made by Peter, a follower of Jesus, who said, "You are the Son of God. You are the Son of God." For Peter to say that meant that he was diverting from everything taught by the religious leaders of that time. Son of the living God. That was the greatest claim of all about Jesus. It reminds me of the trilemma. They call it the trilemma that C.S. Lewis came up with. Actually, it was something that originated in the 19th century, but in Mere Christianity, C.S. Lewis popularized the trilemma. It refers to Jesus as either a liar, a lunatic, or Lord. And the reasoning goes this way, that Jesus claiming to be the Son of God is either a liar, in which case he knew it was wrong and he was deceiving people intentionally, or he was a lunatic, and that was he was self-deceived and didn't really know himself at all. Or he was Lord, which means that he, in fact, is the Son of the living God. And looking at the life of Jesus, it's impossible to see him being a liar or a lunatic. He stands out as Lord. Garrison Keillor once said that you sometimes have to look into the mirror, see reality, and deny it. Well, he was talking about the way we appear maybe as we age. We see that it really is true, but then we deny it. But when it comes to looking at Jesus and we see the evidence, the reality, to deny that makes us dishonest. It makes us completely unfair towards the evidence that is there of Jesus. And so there is a man by the name of John Rabbi Duncan who stated it so well. And let me read it to you. He said that Christ either deceived mankind by conscious fraud, or he was himself deluded and self-deceived, or he was divine. There is no way of getting away from the trilemma. The real question is, who do you believe Jesus is? Are you willing to not just say that he is the Son of the living God, but are you willing to contemplate what that means for you? Because if the reality of that is true in your life, in your mind, and you accept that reality, the very next step is submission to Jesus Christ. And I invite you today to join Peter in saying, "You are the Son of the living God." If you'd like to know more about the Fletcher Seventh-day Adventist Church, you can go to our website at fletchersta.org, and there you'll find that our purpose is to lift Jesus up and love people in.